We're very fortunate to have Cameron Birge from Microsoft Philanthropies. Cameron, welcome.
Thank you.
Something that I was asking about before we got started was Microsoft Philanthropies. I expected it to be a foundation, but it's not.
That's correct. So we are actually a business unit in the company. We made that decision a few years ago when they were restructuring their philanthropic work and their structure. And the decision was made to stay a business unit. There's a number of benefits we realized in it, and the biggest one being how our ease of access across the business for resources to our nonprofit partners and other humanitarian agencies. And having that access, especially at an informal level, is quite powerful and helpful.
What's the difference in a business unit and a foundation in terms of the way Microsoft looks at it?
So the way, there's actually a lot of legal constraints that can take place. A foundation will be a separate entity, at which point your engagement between a foundation and a company, the business processes have to be documented quite well, especially the provision of resources from the business to the foundation. Whereas staying a business unit, we can interact just like that as business units, where teams can just provide us assistance and we can just rely on their good work and their support and not have to worry too much about how it's actually, the documentation behind it, the actual declaration of it is a lot easier to handle, and we can actually just provide more resources.
Microsoft's philanthropic involvement is well known across the world. How do you choose what to do?
We rely a lot on our partners. We try to provide a lot of support through nonprofits, humanitarian agencies. We rely on them and their expertise and their work on the ground, and it's through that partnership network that we sort of decide what to do and how to do it. At the same time, we do have a strategic interest, and we will work on what we are good at. We do have strength in digital skills training, for example, so we support a number of programs around the world. We are going to be heavily involved in countries where we have more of a presence because we have ease of access in those areas. So we will be working towards our strengths with our technology and our knowledge, but supporting our partners for the implementation of those programs.
What's the thing that you yourself, Cameron, like to work on the most?
So my role at Microsoft is I am the humanitarian response manager. So I manage how the company responds to sudden onset humanitarian disasters.
Oh my gosh, you've been busy.
It has been a busy first quarter, I'm not gonna lie. What I really get out of it, though, is actually providing that assistance to those agencies that are making a difference. Tapping into the strength of Microsoft's resources, which is really the people. Our most powerful impact is when we can reach across the company and bring engineers, services, and those different resources to assist an agency with a problem they're having on the ground that has a technical solution component to it that we can assist with. And being able to provide that is thrilling, and it's what I really enjoy doing at Microsoft.
So let's take the refugee crisis in the Middle East, for example. At first glance, I would think, okay, that's where people need water, food, and toilets.
Right.
How can Microsoft fit in there? But you can, can't you?
So that's not our natural strength, but it's also why we work through our partners. So we'll work with a partner, such as Mercy Corps, for example, and supporting them in the education component, while they will be looking at the all-up support for refugees, for refugee assistance, which can include those basic survival needs, but they won't be tapping into our expertise to assist them in. Not what we're good at.
Employees at Microsoft, how are they involved?
In so many ways. First off is their giving. They have generous hearts. Our staff giving campaign runs every year, and we do a company match, so dollar for dollar support for their donation to any nonprofit of their choosing. And so I'm unsure of this year's final number, but I do know the last number was $116 million to thousands of nonprofits. And so our employees give across the board, and it's amazing. They're also very active volunteers. We do match volunteer hours with money to the nonprofit they choose. We have hundreds, if not thousands, of members on boards. And so it's a very active employee community in so many different interests across the country and the world.
One thing for sure is that around the world, Microsoft has had an incredible impact on helping women become economic powers where they were never economically powerful before.
Right.
At the same point in time, that has caused some issues because male-dominated societies don't like it necessarily when women become economic powers. How has Microsoft dealt with that?
We're going to rely heavily on our partners. So it's not going to be Microsoft resources directly to somebody that's going to empower them. Basically, because we don't even have those kinds of resources. We have tools and our technological assistance, but we really rely on those nonprofit partners to use those correctly and to shape them in a way that brings empowerment to women. And they have the difficult situation of navigating the social structures on the ground. And they're the ones who spend that time with the authorities, with the different interests, and trying to navigate very complex and which can be tense situations. We just provide them support behind the scenes so they can run those programs.
Who calls on you most? Is it governments that who have had some kind of disaster where response is needed? Is it NGOs who said we're about ready to go in and we need some help? Or is it your employees are saying, hey, something bad happened and we need to fix this?
Actually, it's a combination of all three. So our employees definitely reach out. They definitely have their interests and they definitely advocate for the things they believe in. And we try to support them the best way that we can, raise awareness, raising funds. Our emergency service teams, which are one of the most valuable things that we can provide, go to both government agencies and nonprofits. So a lot of that will depend on context. There are some areas of the world where the government agencies are strong, but they just might be overwhelmed temporarily due to the emergency and just need a little bit of service support. So in those sort of situations, you'll see the government being the larger recipient of medical support. There's other areas of the world where those institutions aren't quite in place. And so it's the nonprofits who are responding, the NGO community that's responding stronger. And so they'll require more support. So it really will be case by case and dependent on where in the world it's taking place, the nature of the emergency, and the resources on the ground.
Is your program growing?
It is.
Is that a good thing?
For me, no, because I am in the disaster response side, so it has been quite unfortunate, but it is a growing program. All in all, though, Philanthropies itself is growing in Microsoft. As we really formalize our engagement, and we really do treat it as something that requires attention and resources. It's not a side activity, it's not a pastime. It is something with dedicated resources and staffing and a lot of infrastructure behind it.
Cameron, thank you very much for being with us.
Great, thank you very much.
Believes we can change the world, one life, one heart.